Hello class, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good. So students, welcome once again to your maths class. I, Achal Singh, welcoming you all once again to your maths class. So students, as you know, in our previous session, we were discussing the topic from chapter number 9, that is money. Okay, so exercise 9.1 we have already revised. And we have done some of the sums from the exercise 9.2 as well. Okay, so exercise 9.2 that we have started in our previous session, and we have done near about 5 sums from the exercise 9.2. Okay, so today we will continue with the same exercise. So all of you kindly open your books at page number 106. That is exercise 9.2. So that is exercise 9.2 and the page number is 106. Okay, so here in this exercise we have done the sums of addition of money. Okay, so हमने money addition topic that we have done in the previous session. So we have added certain amounts of money together. So today we will start with the next few sums. Okay, so let's begin with sum number 7. Okay, so in sum number 7, okay, so I'm starting with it. Okay, so this is a very little. This is a sum that is given in different parts. Okay, so let's read the sum first. The sum number 7 is, read the following menu and find the amount of each person paid. Okay, so in sum number 7, you can see here that this is the menu. You can suppose you went to, jab bhi aap kisi restaurant ya kisi hotel mein jaate hain to have some lunch or brunch or anything or dinner. So first of all, what they give you? Okay, so the first of all they give you a menu. So whatever you want to order, so आप जो order करना चाहते हो उसके लिए आपको एक menu card देते हैं कि select your items and this is the price of each item and whichever you select we are going to serve you. So this is a menu that they have given. Okay, so the items and the price of all the items is given here. So the in the menu they have written the pizza that cost ₹89, whereas the second is the burger that cost ₹25, quite cheap. Okay, third is patty that cost ₹10.75. Next is coke that cost ₹7. Next, cake that cost ₹12.25. The next is soup. So soup, the soup cost ₹35.50. The last is ice cream. So the cost of ice cream is ₹9.75. So here they have given the name of the items and here they have given their price as well. On the next page, they have given the three questions here in the part A, B and C. So here in A part, they have said, Rinki bought a burger, a soup and an ice cream. B part, Ambika bought a pizza, a cake and a coke. Whereas in the C part, they have said that Sonu bought a pizza, a patty and an ice cream. Okay, so here they have given the three conditions in which three different persons have bought three different items. Okay, in this hotel or whatever the restaurant where they would go. So here in a restaurant, in a hotel, where they went to eat, so here Rinku, Ambika and Sonu, they have three different things that they have ordered. ओके नाउ हमें क्या करना है, सो वी हैव टू फाइंड द अमाउंट फॉर ईच पर्सन विद पे. सो अंबिका, सोनू एंड रिंकू, तो ये तीनों ए बी सी पार्ट में जो अलग अलग इन्होंने आइटम्स मंगाई है, वी आर गोइंग टू कैलकुलेट द टोटल अमाउंट दे आर गोइंग टू पे फॉर द आइटम दे हैव डिमांडेड इन द रेस्टोरेंट. सो वॉट अमाउंट दे आर गोइंग टू पे फॉर दैट आइटम्स दैट दे हैव दे आर ईटिंग इन दिस रेस्टोरेंट. ओके, सो फॉर दिस we will do the sum in the part wise. Okay, so starting with the A part, so first of all we will calculate the amount that to be paid by the Rinku. So how many, how much, sorry, Rinki, not Rinku, it is Rinki. So what amount will be going to be paid by Rinki? So that is question number 7, A part. The A part is, so Rinki bought a burger, a soup and an ice cream. So the cost of burger. देखिए रिंकी ने क्या क्या खरीदा बर्गर शी हैड बॉट बर्गर सूप एंड एन आइसक्रीम कॉस्ट ऑफ बर्गर द कॉस्ट ऑफ बर्गर इज इक्वल टू द कॉस्ट ऑफ बर्गर इज रुपीज 25 सो द कॉस्ट ऑफ बर्गर इज रुपीज 25 दिस इज द कॉस्ट ऑफ बर्गर सेकेंड इज Next, Rinki bought a soup as well. The next is cost of soup. Cost of soup. So the cost of soup is equal to, the cost of soup is equal to rupees 35 rupees and 50 paise. So the cost of soup is 35 rupees and 50 paise. So this is the cost of the soup. Third, she had bought an ice cream. Cost of an ice cream. Cost of an ice cream. So the cost of an ice cream is equal to rupees. The cost of ice cream is rupees 9 rupees and 75 paise. That is 9.75. So this is the cost of ice cream. So that means Rinki had bought a burger which cost rupees 25, the soup which cost rupees 35 and an ice cream which cost 19 rupees and 75 paise. So the total amount she is going to pay, that we will calculate here. Okay. So total amount of all items, your total cost of all items, total cost of all items. Total cost of all items is equal to, let's add them all, rupees 25 rupees and okay plus 35 rupees 50 paise third 9 rupees and 75 paise. Okay, so this is the total cost of all the items. So let's add them. 0 plus 0 plus 5, that will be 5. 5 plus 7, 12. 2, put a dot here. 1 will be carried. 5 plus 5, 10. 10 plus 9, 19. Plus 1, 20. 0, 2. 2 plus 3, 5. 5 plus 2, 7. That is 70 rupees and 25 paise. That is 70 rupees and 25 paise. So that means Rinki is going to pay rupees. The amount paid by Rinki is 70 rupees and 25 paise. So the solution sentence we will write. So they have said what, find the amount each person paid. Okay. So for the A part, we will write the solution sentence. Therefore, Rinki will pay rupees 70 rupees and 25 paise. Therefore, Rinki will pay 75 rupees and 25 paise. So, this will be the amount that will be paid by Rinki. Clear? Chaliye, moving next to the B part. So the B part is, now we have to calculate the amount that will be paid by Ambika. Okay, so let's find out the cost that will be paid by Ambika. That is the B one. So the B part is, so the different items that are being bought by Ambika, let's calculate it as well.
Seventh, B part.
So Ambika has bought a pizza, a cake and a Coke. Okay? A pizza, a cake and a Coke.
So cost of pizza, cost of pizza. The cost of pizza is equal to,
what is the cost of pizza here? That is rupees 89.
So the cost of pizza is equal to rupees 89. Cost of pizza is rupees 89. Second is a cake. Cost of cake. The cost of cake is equal to,
the cost of cake is rupees 12 rupees and 25 paise.
That is 12 rupees and 25 paise. So the cost of cake is 12 rupees and 25 paise.
Third is the cost of a Coke.
Next is cost of Coke. So the cost of Coke, so the cost of Coke is,
that is given here, that the cost of Coke is 7 rupees. So the cost of Coke is rupees
7. So the cost, the Coke cost rupees 7. So let's add them all.
Okay, now add it.
Okay.
So now I'm going to add it here only. So that's why I have written the, देखिए इनको यहीं पे ऐड कर लीजिए ताकि आपको बार बार कैलकुलेशन सेम लिखनी ना पड़े एंड इट विल बी इजी फॉर यू टू कैलकुलेट वेयर एज नाउ यू कैन कैलकुलेट हेयर बट द वन थिंग इफ यू वॉन्ट टू कैलकुलेट हेयर दैट यू हैव टू राइट एवरी डिजिट बिलो द अदर डिजिट एक एक डिजिट नीचे नीचे लिखना होगा ऐसे ऐसे टेढ़ा मेढ़ा लिखोगे बेटा zigzag लिखोगे दैट यू विल नॉट इट विल बी वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर यू टू कैलकुलेट एंड आई एम 110% श्योर दैट द कैलकुलेशन विल बी कंप्लीटली रॉन्ग So for, if you want that your calculation should be absolutely correct, just write each of the word below other, each of the digit below the other one. Clear?
So here 0 plus 5 plus 0 that is 5, 2 plus 0 that is 2, 9 plus 2 11, 11 plus 7 18. Okay, 18. So 1 will be carried forward to the next number. So 8 plus 1, 9 plus 1, that is 10. That is rupees 108 rupees and 25 paise. So this is the total cost of all three items. Total cost of all items. Total cost of all items is equal to 108 rupees and 25 paise.
So this is the cost of all the items that is being bought by Ambika. Okay. So at last we will write the solution sentence.
Therefore Ambika will pay. How much rupee will be paid by Ambika?
So the Ambika will pay 108 rupees and 25 paise.
So Ambika will pay 108 rupees and 25 paise. So this is the amount that will be paid by Ambika.
So Ambika will pay 108 rupees and 25 paise. So this is the solution of the B part of question number 7. Just note it down in your notebook very neatly. Okay? चलिए मूविंग नेक्स्ट टू द सी पार्ट नाउ वी आर मूविंग टू द सी पार्ट ऑफ द सेम क्वेश्चन सो अगेन इन द सी पार्ट द थर्ड पर्सन हु हैड बॉट सम ऑफ द आइटम्स इज सोनू सो नाउ वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट द अमाउंट दैट विल बी पेड बाय सोनू सो हाउ मच अमाउंट इज गोइंग टू बी पेड बाय सोनू दैट वी विल कैलकुलेट इन दिस सी पार्ट So, Sonu bought a pizza, a patty and an ice cream. Okay, so let's calculate the amount. So,
The first thing that Sonu has bought, that is a pizza. So we will write the cost of pizza. The cost of pizza is equal to rupees.
So the cost of pizza is equal to rupees 89. So the cost of pizza is
rupees 89. This is the cost of pizza.
Second is a patty. So the next is the cost of patty.
Cost of patty. PATTY patty. So the cost of patty is
is 10 rupees and 75 paise.
That is 10 rupees and 75 paise. So the cost of patty is
10 rupees and 75 paise. Third is an ice cream.
The third is cost of an ice cream. Cost of an ice cream. Okay.
So the cost of ice cream is rupees. So the cost of ice cream is rupees 9 rupees 75 paise.
So that is 9 rupees and 75 paise. So this is the cost of ice cream. So we will put a zero here. So now let's add the price of all the items, or sorry, the cost of all the items that is being bought by Sonu. So this is the total cost. Now we will find the total cost of all items. Total cost of all items that we will calculate here. Okay. So 5 plus 5, 10, 0, 1. 7 plus 7, 14 plus 1, 15, 5. 15, 1 will be carried forward. So, 5 plus 5, 10, 0 and 1 will be carried here. 7 plus 7, 14 plus 1, 15, 5 here. 1 will be carried forward to the next number. So, 9 plus 9, 18. 18 plus 1, 19. 9, 1 will be carried forward here. 8 plus 1, 9 plus 1. That is 10. So, that is 109 rupees and 50 paise. So this much amount will be paid by Sonu for the item that he has purchased. That is a pizza, a patty and an ice cream. So this is the amount that will be paid by Sonu. Therefore, Sonu will pay. Okay. So Sonu will pay rupees 109 rupees and 50 paise. So therefore Sonu will pay 109 rupees and 50 paise. So this is the C part of question number 7. Okay. So this is the solution of the C part. You can pause it here and note it down in your notebook as well. Okay. So this is the third, the last part from the same sum number 7. Okay, so now in this sum we have calculated the different amount that will be paid by the different person for the different items that they have purchased from a restaurant. Clear? Chaliye, now we will move to the next question number 8. Okay, so let's move to the question number 8. That is question number 8. So the question number 8 is subtract. So now we will subtract the certain amounts that are given here. Subtract the in the 8th sum. Okay, so we have to subtract 89 rupees 50 paise from 190 rupees and 35 paise. Okay, so we have to subtract 89 rupees 50 paise from 190 rupees and 35 paise.
So the amount of the two different amounts that is given, that is subtract.
Okay, so we have to subtract 89 rupees 50 paise from 190 rupees and 35 paise.
89 rupees 50 paise from 190 rupees 35 paise. Okay, so let's subtract. देखिए, here it is written 89 rupees 50 paisa from 190 rupees and 35 paise. So that means we have to subtract this 89 rupees 50 paise from इसमें से. So this is the bigger one, this is the small amount. So definitely we will always subtract the smaller amount from the bigger amount. Okay, so let's subtract rupees 190 rupees and 35 paise minus 89 rupees and 50 paise. Okay, so let's subtract it. Okay, so we will simply subtract it. I have put a zero. If you don't want, you can just skip it as well. चलिए, 5 minus 0, 5. 3 minus 5. Is it possible to subtract 3 for 5? 5 from 3? No, so it will borrow from the next number. But this is also 0, so that means this 0 is going to borrow from here, from the 9. So 9 after giving 1 to the 0, it will become 8 and it will become 10. Whereas after borrowing, as 3 had borrowed from 10, 3 ne isse borrow kiya tha, so it will become 13 and it will become 9. Okay, so let's, now we can easily subtract 5 from 13. So 13 minus 5, 8. Okay, 9 minus 9, 0. 8 minus 8, 0 and 1. Okay, so just simple, this is just a simple subtraction that you are doing from class 1, you are going to do here as well. Okay, so after subtracting on 89 rupees 50 paise from 190 rupees 35 paise, we got 100 rupees and 85 paise. This is the amount that is being left. So let's write the answer. So the answer is 100 rupees and 85 paise. So this is the amount that is 100 rupees and 85 paise. Okay, so this is the solution of subtraction of sum number 8. Clear? Chaliye, moving next to the sum number 9. Okay, this is also, okay, the next few sums that are related to the subtraction only. So in the 9th sum, we will subtract 176 rupees 25 paise from 193 rupees and 8 paise. Okay, so in the 9th sum, we have to subtract 176 rupees 25 paise from 193 rupees and 8 paise. Okay, so let's subtract them. So first of all, let's write the statement, that is rupees 176 rupees and 25 paise from 193 rupees and 8 paise. Okay, so let's subtract it. Okay, so let's subtract it. So first of all, we will write it in the column form. So rupees 193 rupees and 8 paise minus 176 rupees and 25 paise. So let's subtract it, rupees. Okay, so now we have to subtract 176 rupees 25 paise from 193 rupees and 8 paise. Okay, so 8 minus 5, 3.
8 minus 5 is 3. So 0 minus 2, is it possible? No. So it will borrow from here and this 3 will become 2. It will become 10. So 10 minus 2, 10 minus 2 will be 8. Okay. Dot 2 minus 6, is it possible to subtract 6 from 2? No. So this 2 will borrow from the next number 9. It will become 8 and it will become 12. So 12 minus 6 is 6. 8 minus 7, 1. 1 minus 1, 0. Okay, so the answer we got after subtracting 176 rupees 25 paise from 193 rupees 8 paise, that is 16 rupees and 83 paise. So let's write the answer separately. That is 16 rupees and 83 paise. So this is the amount, that is 16 rupees and 83 paise that we have got after subtracting 176 rupees 25 paise from 193 rupees and 8 paise. Clear? Chaliye, moving next to the 10th question. Okay, so you can pause it here and note it down in your notebooks as well. Chaliye, moving to the question number 10. That is also related to the subtraction only. So in question number 10, we have to subtract 375 rupees 85 paise from 690 rupees. Okay, so let's subtract 375 rupees 85 paise from 690 rupees. So the amount that of sum number 10 is given, that is 375 rupees 85 paise from 690 rupees. Okay, so let's subtract it. Okay, so rupees 690 minus rupees 375 rupees and 85 paise. So let's subtract it and find the answer. 0 minus 5, not possible. No, 0 is not now. So they will directly borrow from here. So this 9 will become 8 and it will become 10. Okay, ye 10 ban jayega. Now this 0 will borrow from here. So it will become 9 and it will become 10. But this 0 also requires a borrow. So this will borrow from here as it is 10 now. So it will ultimately become 9 and this will become 10. Okay. Now we can do the calculations or the subtraction very easily here. So 10 minus 5, 5. 9 minus 8, 1. 9 minus 5, 4. Okay. 8 minus 7. That is 8 minus 7 is 1. Next, 6 is here. 6 minus 3 is 3. So, after subtracting after subtracting 375 rupees 85 paise from 690 rupees, we got the amount, that is 314 rupees and 15 paise. So, that's why we will write the answer separately as well. That is, okay, don't forget to put the rupee mark wherever it is required. So this rupee mark is very much important. Okay, that is 314 rupees and 15 paise. So that is 314 rupees and 15 paise. Okay, so this is the solution of question number 10 from exercise 9.2. Okay, class. So the next question number 11, that is also related to the subtraction of the two different amounts, and just you will do this one will by yourself only. Okay, so just this is a simple subtraction beta, just try to do it yourself. Okay, after that we will start with the statement sums from the exercise 9.2. okay, so that we will continue in the next session.
Okay, class. So this I'm ending the today's session here only. So I'll see you again very soon in our next session. So till then, everybody, have a good day.